Lumolobo po ang utang ng Pilipinas. By the end of January of this year, umabot ito sa 7.76 trillion. Kung ikukumpara yan doon sa simula ng administration ni President Duterte, it was around at 5 trillion. Ano? Mm. Some say that yung utang is inevitable. Pero Richard, ano tingin mo dito sa trend na ito?
Well, Atong, first of all, there's some good news naman. One of the good news is for the very first time, magiging contributor tayo doon sa Asian Development Fund, sa may Asian Development Bank, no? This is the first time we're doing that. That means that yung overall economic and fiscal conditions natin ay nag-improve as we become an upper middle income country, no? So nagiging net lender tayo. The second thing is as guys, pagdating sa debt, especially foreign debt, ang issue dito is always not the volume per se, pero yung sustainability base doon sa pag-grow ng country mo at paano mo ginagamit yung new debt into investing in terms of your capacity, no? Kasi kung yung inutang mo, nilagay mo naman sa productivity ng bansa mo at nag-expand lalo yung economy mo, you'll be able to pay back that debt. So huwag tayong magpanic. And the other thing also is this administration has also inherited a lot of debt, including all the way from the Marcos time. So it's not like the Duterte administration came in with a clean slate. Nonetheless, Atom, one of the things that we have to look at is this, yung nag-increase ng foreign debt natin by around 33.51 billion pesos. The spending of this government is a little bit getting out of control habang the two previous administrations were spending a lot. The other thing is, we know that there's more and more money coming in terms of infrastructure development fund, especially from China, no? Hindi pa ganun kalaki, but I think the concern here is that yung money na pumapasok dito, what are the transparency or accountability measures to ensure that sustainable ito at nilalagay ito sa tamang investments, no? Is this odious debt? Is this a debt that is productive or is this a debt that goes to corruption and non-productive investments? So quality, no, of those debts and investments is also very much important here.